Whisper and Thunder, the whisper of Native American stories, the thunder of stories that demand to be told. Journey of the Message by Pat Estes, featuring her painting by the same title. Patricia felt her eyes opening wider and wider. Her heart's energy fluttered intimately with the shades and depth of the story about to be unleashed. Wolf begins. God, Source, Creator, whatever each of us chooses to refer to him or it as, or believe him or it to be, is always out there in the depths of the universe. He keeps a close eye on his children, constantly trying to communicate to us, guide us, answer our prayers, let us all know how much we are loved and cared for. We are never forgotten, and we are never alone. Creator sends his teachings and messages by summoning Spirit Eagle to the heavens. Eagle flies and soars the highest of all birds, which is why Creator has chosen him. Great Spirit Eagle, reliable and trustworthy, he is the messenger. Eagle glides to the ridge where Earth kisses the heavens, and it is here. Creator gives Eagle a sacred message meant for us. Eagle then descends tirelessly until he comes upon his brother Hawk. Of all bird species, Spirit Hawk has the most advanced and keenest gift of sight. Hawk has the ability to focus and find the one Creator's message is meant for. Hawk sees all and knows all. If you ever catch a glimpse of one floating freely in the sky, he serves as a reminder to you to focus on your life and stick to your path. Hawk climbs in his ascension once he spots Eagle floating towards him, exchanging respectful, brotherly glances. They carousel beautifully to their rendezvous, the sacred space in mid-sky where spirits of the outer world lovingly embrace the earthly spirits of this world, the place where pink and orange collide, way up high in the sky. If you are lucky, you may catch a momentous sunrise or sunset being born here. After a brief exchange, Hawk receives the message from Brother Eagle, and so starts the next phase of the journey. Hawk playfully tickles the wind with his feathered fingertips as the distance grows between the two. It is now he searches for his younger brother, Crow. They too share rich blood, but their story to that effect will have to be told another time. Spirit Crow often sits perched on his favorite tree limb. No matter where, he is there. Crow's gift is that he does not hesitate to speak truth or wisdom. He pays attention to every detail below, yet never neglects the importance of things happening directly above. And it is at this moment Crow notices his brother Hawk, boldly circling, not too far above him. Eagerly, Crow leaps into the air to greet Hawk. It has been a while. As the two of them draw near, their secret exchange in the sky mirrors the power and essence of an epic solar eclipse. As if liquid gold combines easily with molten black lava. This is now the time for Crow and Hawk to dance their duet in the lower skies. Crow tells many lighthearted jokes and fills Hawk in on all the latest gossip. He presents him with a tidy report of all current events since last visit passed. Hawk appreciates the tenacity of Brother Crow and often marvels at how he is able to embrace both worlds, the air and the earth. Hawk is also in awe of Crow's pronounced voice, for there is no question as to who is speaking. When Crow speaks, all listen. Exchanging gentle brushes of talons, the message is then again transferred. Hawk respectfully says his goodbyes before disappearing back into the sun's rays from which he came. Crow momentarily watches Brother Hawk disappear into St. Elmo's fire. It is now up to Crow to finish the last leg of the journey. To complete the deliverance of Creator's message, he begins by seeking out the one true individual chosen to receive this gift from above. Once the intended has been found, Crow will then translate the message from Creator via his powerful Ka. When Crow finds you, me, someone else, he will squawk and caw to gain your attention. Our eyes will lock with his, and a sacred connection will be made. It is at this moment you will know, beyond any and all doubt, that a message from Creator has traveled a great distance to be delivered unto you, and you alone. Wolf now pauses after speaking this Lakota legend. Patricia's mouth drops open like a hungry pelican. The Lakota truth has her utterly mesmerized and surely curious to know just a tiny bit more, asking, "How does one know what Crow is telling me?" Wolf smiling wider now. "It is simple," he says. "As the receiver, it is up to you to decipher with your heart what the message is, as it is bestowed to you from Creator. Either it is truth or it is wisdom. Your heart knows the answer. For instance, whatever is in your heart, whether heavy or contemplative, at the exact point Crow speaks to you, then it is truth. Just the same, whatever is on your mind, whether philosophical or seemingly unsolvable at the time Crow squawks, then it is wisdom. Only you and you alone can understand the sacred message from Creator." Silence now breathes between them. She can do nothing more than remain quiet, delicately processing all that has been told, all which has been made known, digesting this Lakota legend with her heart and spirit, layers of thoughts and clarity stepping forth. A wise chuckle has Wolf asking, "Do you know the significance of the ceremonial peace pipe?" Patricia can only answer honestly by stating she understands the importance and beauty, but respectfully cannot claim to know the proper truth. Wolf nods. Pressing on, he explains to her, "In Lakota tradition, during ceremonies involving a peace pipe, there are times when one of two things can happen. As the pipe is passed around from one person to the next, and before smoking from it, each has the opportunity to tell a story, to share information, teachings, enlightenment. When the speaker is finished, should they decide to smoke from the pipe, the act of smoking confirms the truth that has been spoken. But if the speaker does not smoke from the pipe after sharing, then it becomes clear to all, the story or teaching which has been told is a work of fiction. It was meant to entertain, lighten the mood, perhaps an attempt to invoke a deeper level of thinking and understanding. Patricia, if I had a peace pipe with me today, I would at this time smoke from it. Oh, one last thing." Hearty laughter escapes from Wolf. "The same is true in reverse when considering the journey of the message from Creator. The delicate line of communication with Creator remains open at all times. By utilizing the same means Creator chooses to communicate with us, we in turn can send our prayers, praise, and personal messages back up to Him. Only for us, it is done in reverse. We may choose to verbalize, use telepathic means, even simply will our messages to Brother Crow. Crow travels back to Brother Hawk, who in turn climbs the skies back to Brother Eagle. From here, Eagle finishes the final passage by summoning Creator with his powerful cry. Creator then accepts these loving messages from his beloved children, and a wondrous cycle continues." Finally, Wolf asked Patricia, "So, what did Crow tell you? What was your message from Creator?" He had wanted to mention she did not have to share this information with him. He simply wanted to see if she understood, but Patricia was so darn excited, she began her revelation rather immediately. The two continued to converse and enjoy each other's company. Wolf now listens, and Patricia speaks. Soon their voices are swept up, like feathers in the wind, by the afternoon breeze flurrying in through a nearby open window. Hearts growing stronger, spirits shining brighter, the air moves and circulates in and around, eventually sweeping up and out back from the window, it crept in through. The wind suddenly takes flight. One can barely hear the voices of friends carrying on just inside the tavern now, floating and soaring on the fabric of Sister Wind, saying hello as it passes Brother Crow perched in a nearby tree, climbing higher and higher, smiling as it wisps by Brother Hawk. Soon gentle kisses are blown to Brother Eagle, brushing the tips of his powerful feathers. Back out into the universe it carries, back to the source from which it came. From Creator, God, Source, it is all the same and true unto each. Out there in the depths of the universe, Sister Wind shapeshifts into an immaculate robe of crystal blue ice. With a flash, the fabric bursts into a multitude of directions, each sparkling essence finding its proper place. New smiles, shining bright stars, twinkling, laughing, cheering with awe-inspiring luminosity. The universe and all stars remain joyous and proud. They celebrate with amazing grace, for a fellow shooting star seed has transcended the boundaries of Earth once more. It had embraced our mother with love and enriched her great wisdom as seen from above. On this day, this particular star seed calls himself White Wolf, honorably sharing his ancient Lakota wisdom, and most certainly there is more. White Wolf continues to spread his gifts. They are not gifts one simply puts on a shelf and stares at. No, his gifts remind us all to honor and love ourselves. And with that, we must each remember that we too have gifts and wisdom to share. They are a part of us, and they will never leave. So why not share them today?